Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. I'll be sharing with you on how I use Notion. This video is not sponsored. I'm just sharing something that has been helping me with organizing my life. So Notion is kind of like a bullet journal but in a digital form, which also explains why I'm a huge fan of it. I use it on my iPad as well as my laptop. And I saw way too many YouTube mutuals using it, so I had to try it out myself. What I noticed is that Notion really knows where to get their audience. I was mainly attracted by aesthetic displays from other users where they have these organized and pretty dashboards. The whole pretty Pinterest board in a single screen, if that's the concept you're talking about. Alright, so let's take a view at my Notion dashboard. I'll guide you on making a pretty Notion setup later. I don't like multiple pages, so one is enough for me to organize my messed up life. So what you see here is that I have all the parts from to-do list to monthly to-do list, work and goals all separate so I can focus on just one specific thing at a time. So on the top, I have a cute teddy bear as a small profile picture with one of my favorite quotes on the bottom. Moving down, I have a May to July goals slash list of things I need to accomplish. On the right, my main goal of having Notion is to organize work, yes, YouTube, and also my non-existent online shop which will probably start soon. I have videos and sponsorships both in different pages to not stress me out, and on my videos page, I created a board to also categorize my videos in not started, in progress, and also completed. It helps me to keep track of what I have and have not done so my uploading schedule stays consistent. And I'm not going to give you guys an inside view of sponsorship, so let's move on to my daily to-do list. My daily to-do list is best to use when I have to edit or publish a video or either create a product for my upcoming shop. So you can see that I have a lot of things I need to do for the day and I don't necessarily complete them in a day because I'm really lazy. So moving on next, I also created a yearly goal section. So there's travel plans, which is not going to happen at this time of the year. In this specific section, I also have yearly goals, my plans with my boyfriend, and also monthly expenses. So the monthly expenses page is one of the pages I use the most, and monthly plans in a calendar page, which did not work out for me. So basically, things that may work for me might not work for you, or things that may work for you may not work for me. So just explore and you will find what works best for you. Last but not least, I have a movie list, but honestly, I don't really use it. But if you're a huge movie fan or binge watching any shows, you will have tons of fun working away with this feature. And now I will guide you step by step on how to use Notion, and it's pretty simple. First, you will have to go on Pinterest to get some nice pictures. You can use your own photos if you prefer so. Once you're done compiling all photos together, go to Notion and create a page. When creating a page, it's blank. I will always upload a cover photo and then click the icon to change the image. Most of the pictures are from Pinterest. You can also use animated images for the cover photo and icon. I'll start off by clicking heading 2, which is my favorite, and the first section I will do is the to-do list, and selecting the color I want. The color for this specific page will be brown, so I will just try to create a template so you guys can use it. After the heading, click the plus button and press the to-do list feature, and then you can fill up your task. And now I'll be adding a Spotify playlist. All you have to do is go on Spotify, click any playlist, and copy the link. Then on Notion, click video, and then insert the link, and your Spotify playlist will be displayed. Next, I'm creating another heading with the label Me. I want this part to be all about me, which includes my goals, expenses, and more. To separate each part, I will create a page. A page is perfect when you want to separate any tasks or categories on Notion. I created two pages, one for expenses and one for goals. This gives you a clearer scope for what you have to fill in so you are more organized. And now the expenses tracker. As usual, I change the icon and cover image, and then I proceed with adding a table. A table is perfect for an expenses tracker, one for the date, item, and price, easy to manage with. And obviously you can work with whatever you want, it doesn't have to be in this way, so feel free to try other things yourself and just find what works best for you. For example, I put groceries for the first expenses in my tracker. Next up is goals. More selections. You can choose to have financial goals, self-care goals, study goals, family goals, and many more. Again, this is your dashboard, so feel free to do whatever you prefer. I'll be using a self-care goal, study goal, and finance goal for this page. So here's what I love about Notion. You get to create a page in a page. So in this goals page, we can create more pages for each goal category. I hope you understand what's going on, and Notion is pretty easy to use. In this self-care page, I'm just using a to-do list system. I am also applying the same method for the rest of the goals too. And now to organize my board, you can simply drag and move things around. And of course, if you want to add new headings, new playlists, or even add more things, go ahead. I even added an image just to make my board look brighter. I also moved the image around to where I find looks best, so yeah. Just sharing another favorite of mine, which is adding a quote. Here's one of my favorite quotes. You either fall in love with the truth or your favorite illusion. I did not like the font on the quote feature, so I just changed it into a regular text. It looks so much better and romantic. Last but not least, I'll show you how to make a movie list. So first create a heading of your choice and label whatever you want, then click video, copy a link of a show you want to watch, and then insert the link. I chose Haikyuu for this one. I recently started watching anime and all I have been watching is just anime. It's really an addiction and I can't wait to finish Haikyuu. Alright, so that's just a simple and quick tutorial on how to use Notion. If you have been confused on how to use it, I hope this helps and thank you for stopping by. Click the like and subscribe button now and follow me on my Instagram, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!